Warrior Jungle.
Democracy, equity, fairness, and social justice. We advocate and campaign for the decongestion of correctional centers in Nigeria. In view of our activities above, we welcome you all to this historical press conference on the current state of our dear nation, Nigeria. On October 1st, 1960, marked the beginning of our independence as a nation. On that day, the heroes of the nationalist struggle and all Nigerians were full of hopes and dreams. The citizens of the new country danced in color celebration of the newfound freedom. Nigerians were filled with so much expectation as the Union Jack was lowered and the green, white, green flag of Nigeria was raised in its place. A new journey has started. On a road that had never been taken before, the future was pregnant with promises, patriotism, and pragmatism. Our founding fathers shattered the cause to greatness of this country, and the people they made compromises and sacrifices. They toiled night and day to build a viable country where progress, peace will reign supreme. Our independence was gained by men and women who envisioned a land of freedom and one of the posterity for all, a country of justice and equity. However, today, these dreams and expectations are not only unfulfilled, our people are despair giving up on the country. All these are born out of justifiable sense of frustration. Fellow citizens and comrades, the recent event and happening in our country, and indeed in our various states, clearly shows that we have lost it and that we have no good government nor leadership. The COVID-19 have clearly shown the total lack of needed infrastructure, system and process in nation building sustenance, the failure of the successive government to put the larger majority at the center stage of the developmental process. Ladies and gentlemen, on Sunday, 29th day of March, 2020, the Nigerian President, President Muhammadu Buhari, in a nationwide broadcast, forcefully imposed a 14-day lockdown on Lagos State, Ogun State, and the Federal Capital Territory, Abuja, with the excuse to contain the spread of COVID-19, effect from 11 p.m. on Monday, 30th day of March 2020. At the expiration of the first 14 days, Mr. President, in another nationwide broadcast, extended the lockdown by slamming us with another 14 days that lasts on Monday, 27th day of April 2020. It is on record that throughout the month of April 2020, Ogun State and Lagos State, the industrial and economical capital of Nigeria, were shut down, stopping all economic and social activities within the period. The lockdown policy, according to Mr. President, was aimed at curtailing and stopping the spread of COVID-19 virus. But it ended up meaningless as we witnessed increase of the virus across the country, and this inflicted and has continued to inflict untold hardship and sufferings on the Nigerian masses in a country where majority of our populace lives on their daily earning and wages. What we're saying is that the lockdown, by locking Nigeria down for 14 days, another 14 days, without putting up a viable measure their so-called palliative was not getting down to where it's supposed to. Nigerians were not seeing anything. Then noise started from every nook and cranny of Nigeria. We want to go out, we want to go out. And the few palliatives the government claimed to be sharing were shared among their party members in the various local government and FCDs that some of us witnessed. The real vulnerables that were supposed to benefit from the palliatives were not getting it. And you and I know that in Nigeria today, majority of our populace live on daily income. So by locking them down without any alternative or any palliative measure, it's more or less that, it's more or less you want them to run away from coronavirus and die of hunger virus. It is no longer news that during the lockdown period, hoodlums, cultists, armed robbers who are unable to make their daily extortion started visiting homes to wreak havoc on the people that were already traumatized by the unexpected lockdown. It was open and it was widely recorded, the security challenge during the lockdown. Even when it was obvious that nobody had anything at home again, even to eat, then armed robber was on rampage, visiting community in numbers. Different names of cultist groups spring up, 1 Million Boys, Awawa Boys. So all these people keep on terrorizing the community. On broad daylight, not in the night as it used to be. Because themselves, where they ought to have gotten their money on a daily basis is not coming. They let us go and meet people inside. Even the people they want to go and meet does not even have what to eat. We have seen picture and video, pictorial and video evidences where people were injured, when their home was raided. And this is part of the challenge. People that make their money daily. And for your information, the first lockdown was a bit easier for some Nigerians because it came at the end of the month where some of the salary earners have gotten some money to stock foods at home. But the second lockdown is nothing to write home about because it's full of complaint. And government, we have seen the government through their Minister of Humanitarian, what have you, claiming they are sharing palliatives, financial cash, bailout or stimulus to people in some part of the country which is not getting down. We have had the Senate agitating, like there's one Senate plenary when Adeyemi was hammering on somebody squandered 100 billion naira and still walking free in the street of Nigeria. If the Nigerian government is claiming to have spent over 100 billion naira for stimulus or palliatives, like we have said before in one of our press statements, they need to investigate how the money was spent. Those who are in charge to share this stimulus and palliatives. Some people, because of this COVID-19, some people have become rich because they have opportunity to corner what is supposed to be made for the public, for the populace, to corner it for themselves or to benefit it to their party members alone. On Monday, 27th day of April 2020, the president tactically extended the lockdown, announcing easing of the lockdown in Ogun State, Lagos State, and Abuja, with effect from 9 a.m. on Monday, 4th of May 2020, and imposed a curfew from 8 p.m. to 6 a.m., then pronounced a 2-week lockdown in Kano State, while putting measures in place to still address the spread of the same coronavirus pandemic he promised to address in the first lockdown since 29th of March 2020. My brother, the excuse the president gave Nigerians then, not Nigerians, to the residents of Lagos, Ogun, and Abuja was that they discovered that to ensure we stop the spread of this pandemic, let everybody remain indoor. The lockdown begins. Some of us were agitated that this lockdown, the lockdown is supposed to come after necessary measures have been put in place, like you have given the people palliatives 2-3 weeks before the announcement of the lockdown. Then you claim that you are going to give them palliatives in your speech, and at the end of the palliatives were not given to the vulnerable. Even when the announcement of 20,000 naira to give to the vulnerable was announced, the vulnerables were not getting it. It become what we are seeing on social media, on electronic media, that some people collect 20,000, some people did not collect money. So that first lockdown, the second lockdown is now tactically he extended. Instead of him to come up and say, "We are extending it, we are calling up the lockdown," the president don't want to announce to Nigeria that the lockdown continue. He said it's easing down the lockdown and tactically extend it another week, 1 week. The promise he made then was that they want to arrest this COVID-19. They want to stop the spread. Since on 29th of March 2020, between 29th of March to 27th of April, there was no meaningful results being achieved by the government on this virus. Rather than we got increase in numbers of index cases. The Center for Human and Socioeconomic Rights believe that the easing the lockdown at this critical time is wickedness on the part of our government, as the federal government action is not the best decision when the index cases are still increasing on a daily basis. Therefore, Nigerians should pray very well so that God will not allow us to experience the situation the likes of Italy, France, Spain, America, and others find themselves in this wicked easing of the lockdown, when the testing capability of Nigeria, the instrument to test the testing capability of this virus, is still below expectation. The coronavirus COVID-19 pandemic has exposed the weakness of our public health system and showed the way in which many things are supposed to be done, as it is obvious that the people at the end of affair in Nigeria do not have any plan for we the poor. Before the first lockdown, it is on record that Nigeria has only 111 confirmed cases of coronavirus in about 12 states, with only one death all over the Federation. Within a week of the first lockdown, Nigeria has recorded over 300 confirmed cases of coronavirus. And in the second round of the additional 14 days, the confirmed cases has increased with about 300%, and the death toll rises. What we are saying is that even before the lockdown, we have lesser number. And during the lockdown, instead of us to have a result that people have been treated, we are not recording new cases, the number keep increasing every day. In the NCDC report, the number keep increasing every day. So within a week, we have scored over 300. And after 2 weeks again, we have scored above 1,000. And at that time, the president considered it, let us release these people to go out, instead of them to put in corrective measure. Since Monday 4th of May 2020, Nigerians from far and near, most especially in Lagos and Ogun, have started going about their daily affairs without care or fear of the virus. In fact, some Nigerians at this point still don't believe that this COVID-19 is real. The federal government should have addressed the issue of the palliative by ensuring it gets down to the vulnerable Nigerians instead of easing the lockdown and leaving Nigerians to their fate after wasting the whole 34 days in lockdown without any meaningful result of arresting the COVID-19 pandemic. The state and federal government should be blamed for allowing the virus to spread beyond control by the level of our public health sector. And if it continues this way, the worst may happen. Many people will be left to die as treatment will be according to your status. Because if you come at cost, then it will be the masses that will suffer. Curfew. The idea of implementing curfew in Lagos State and Ogun State between the hour of 8 p.m. in the evening to 6 a.m. in the morning cannot work in Lagos State due to the traffic congestion in the state. Presently in Lagos State, by virtue of the laid down rules and due to the special social distancing policy being introduced since the outbreak of the COVID-19, the Lagos State Ministry of Transportation has given directives to all commercial vehicles operators to ensure that they don't load beyond 60% of their total capacity of their vehicle, and the BRT buses must not carry more than one passenger per seat. With this, the movement of commuter to and fro their various destinations and to beat the 8 p.m. deadline is not achievable. Rather, it will create an ample opportunity for law enforcement agents to extort and molest Lagosians under the pretense of extorting a so-called presidential order on curfew. We hereby call on the Lagos State government and its Ogun State counterpart to, as a matter of urgency, call on the president to revise the curfew and look for another measure to avoid creating anarchy in our state. And we hereby demand as follows. We demand for a new national population census with immediate effect from the first day of June 2020 without any delay. We demand for state residence data census for an effective social welfare policy and system for all the citizens. We demand for the Chapter 2 of the 1999 Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria to be made justiciable. Finally, lastly on our demand, we demand for the consideration of 75% of the total capacity of the commercial vehicle to be loaded in the interest of the operator's socio-economic life and that of the commuters that will pay the fares. Comrades and compatriots, this is the time to talk and time to act. This is the time to mobilize. This is time to organize and organize to take the right step and action. We wish all the victims of the coronavirus currently receiving treatment in their different centers in Nigeria a quick recovery, as we also sympathize with the family and friends of those that could not survive the battle with the coronavirus COVID-19 pandemic. Finally, we pray that may the Almighty God in His infinite mercy take control and heal the world from this deadly coronavirus pandemic. Thank you once again for coming. God bless Nigeria. God bless Lagos State. God bless the Nigerian masses. The people united can never be defeated. Thank you.
Sir, I highly announced false and sins in the journalism. Sir, your statement, you said that the easing of the lockdown was noting the wickedness on the part of our government.
Yes.
But the government itself has said that due to the public outcry, that they are being killed by hunger. That is why they decided to do this. What do you think could have been the best way of solving the crisis between the pandemic and the hunger outcry of the people?
Okay. Let me respond. Another question
is that you mentioned somewhere that the Lagos State and the state government should call on the president to find means of relaxing the COVID. In what sense is that, and what do you think should be the way out? And lastly, we've had other countries in Africa, Madagascar, and Senegal, going the traditional way of healing this, of taking care of this COVID. What's your suggestion in Nigeria and going this way also, instead of rushing people to the isolation center where there seems to be no cure? Thank you very much.
Wickedness on lockdown, on easing of the lockdown, the curfew, and the African countries' traditional way. Let me respond to that first. Yes, it is wickedness on the part of the government. By starting what you know you cannot end, it's better you don't start at all. If the government, this is at the right time, this government supposed to have act. When you discover that during the lockdown, there's increase in index cases. Before we even went from lockdown to lockdown, we have limited numbers of cases. All over the country, we have only one death. All over the federation, 1, 2 in different states, we have 111. During the lockdown, we expected to be reducing numbers or stop, and all the numbers should not be increasing. But what the reverse is the case. What we see is in an increment, and that shows that, and then that should tell the government that we need to put in a serious measure to this. Maybe the way and manner they were approaching the pandemic before is not, they have to change gear. You understand? Rather than saying we are easing the lockdown, when you know, even at the time they are easing the lockdown, we have recorded over 1,000. When people go indoor, under 112, 111, not up to 112. When you are releasing them to the border to go, at risk is over 1,000. That shows wickedness. Instead of easing the lockdown, what the government ought to have done is that, is to address the deficit all over the country is a singular demand and agitation. Let them go outside, and for your information, as I'm talking to you now, we have exceeded 3,000. And we are still counting. We are still counting. If you are now 3,000 from 111, no any measure, no any address, we are only hearing that some people have been healed. You can see what happened in Kobe. And that's why some Nigerians don't believe there is COVID-19 in Nigeria. If truly those people on the streets in Gombe are coronavirus positive patients, definitely the state is well doomed. Because leaving them, coming out from the isolation center and protest, can somebody that have coronavirus protest? Well, we are not part of the people that don't believe the COVID-19 in Nigeria. Our nation is of most interest that this pandemic should be addressed rather than allow people to go down on risk. Because coming here all the way from our various, and that's why we make it social distance. Some of the media cannot join us here. Well, that's why we think they have to join us online. And some get our speech a soft copy. It's wickedness. Rather than government to address the issue of palliatives and stimulus, they end up, and it's another way of covering their bad deeds. They have announced to Nigerians that they have spent so much money. And if the lockdown continues, they will still spend more than that. And if you get to a state, Nigeria will ask questions. So it's better we allow them to go. It is wickedness, we still insist. It's wickedness on the part of the government. And the issue of curfew. The curfew cannot work in Lagos, considering the fact that Lagos is a populous state of over 20 million Nigerians. And traffic is another of the day in Lagos. You don't walk around the street of Lagos one day, you don't witness traffic. Even during the lockdown, we experienced traffic in Lagos.
Yes.
So, by saying people should come in between 8 o'clock to 6 a.m., in Lagos State, people work 24 hours. Some people were living, they were living at Ikorodu. Some were living in Songo, working on the island. They are also at the island. And for them to move from island to Songo, you know what it means? You witness what a challenge to people living in Ikorodu. You cannot leave island by 5 p.m. and tell me you can get to Ikorodu by 9. It's not possible. It's not possible. So that curfew, and the police have started seizing that opportunity to extort Nigerians. We have received several complaints that they are coming from work. Police stopped them and they have started arresting them. And we alert the government that this is going to be what is going to happen. Because every law, every policy of the government is an ample opportunity for law enforcement agents to extort citizens. And that's why we say this issue of lockdown, curfew, cannot work. And why we emphasize that this can result to anarchy is that, you know, Nigerians, they are just coming out of the lockdown. No money. Even businesses are not going now. Then they are coming, some of the angry Nigerians coming from work. And you know, some of our policemen, all our agencies, some of them, despite their training, some of them lack manner of addressing anybody with anger. So, if you stop somebody, and by virtue of their belief is that every policeman stopping you on the road want to collect money from your hand, then it may aggravate anger. And this may result to abuse, assault of Nigerians by the law enforcement agent. So it is better we don't allow the lockdown to stay at all. There can be another measure the government can put in place than saying we want coffee. And mind you, even there are other states that were not mentioned by the president, who in their own wisdom, the government locked down the states. The traditional, the Africans, yes, we have said it before, that it's only Nigerians, we don't value, especially we the black, don't value ourselves. I am not surprised that the Madagascars were coming up with a local herb to cure coronavirus. If by this, their description, that coronavirus comes with the symptoms of cold, fever, I'm a typical Yoruba man. Yoruba have their ways of treating fever, even to the point of locally, Nigerians treat asthma. Nigerians treat tuberculosis. And these are the indices of the so-called coronavirus. And we have seen some Nigerians who have even come online. Some have come to the social media, some have gone on television media, electronic media, to announce and volunteer themselves that they are ready to treat any coronavirus positive patients free. Nigeria should test them. We even have one of our members, is a member of our mother organization, CDHR, who even did a sample that they should test it, that he believed after 4 days, anybody that tested positive should go out after consuming that one, about half a liter, be sure that person will test negative. But it's not taking. They were asking him, he should come and tell them what he used to produce and the process. And he said, no. That if you need me to do it, I'll do it. What you need to do is to give me, let me consume it myself, for you to show I'm not giving you poison. Now, Madagascar I beat everybody to that, to it. Madagascar is country to beat now. Even the Americans who are patronizing them. We so much believe in the Western world than ourselves. There's nothing impossible. There's nothing, I am not a traditionalist, but what I believe that there's nothing harm cannot cure. So far it's a disease. So far it's a virus. It can be treated. It can be treated locally. And I will also implore Nigerian government to look inward and begin to recognize our traditional herb makers. Give them opportunity to test run their herb. The same way Madagascar came up with one, I know it don't just start a day. There are processes to that before they arrive at that junction. So Nigeria can as well start. So we should not always be depending on white man result. And it's also, you know, it has become a record. Every virus, every disease that comes, solution don't come from Africa. We always wait for solution to be announced by the British, by the Americans, or the Europeans. Now it's China doctor, Chinese doctor, that are coming to handle our solution centers. We have a rumor from a journalist I've called to ask us to inform us the strategy and the what they call achievement in discharging patients of coronavirus. The reason we will not mention that on here now is because the journalist is not here. He called to ask us that this is what they have, what is happening. We learned that in isolation center in the state, we don't want to mention now because the journalist is not here, that in the state, the isolation center, they discharge patients that must have spent 2 weeks or above. Then they give them drugs. Why they are going to test them negative and they are still positive? So that's that. Another question.
Olakunle, I'm calling from TV Shabon, right? Now, in an answer to the question the previous man asked, the journalist had shared, he asked a very vital question that if the number is in, if Nigerians are hearing or the public complain that they are hungry, the hunger virus is going through them, and the government has postponed the lockdown twice, thinking that they'll be able to reach the similar packages to Nigerians who are hungry, but they failed. In fact, from a reasonable quarter, or from a verifiable quarter, I got an information that they were only sharing 4 rice among the primary team that they were sharing to Nigerians. The Nigerians who received those primary team from government, the rice in it was 4, because the rice was the rice that had been kept in the store.
My name is Olasanba Abdul. I report for Peculiar Television. My question goes thus, and it's central on one of your demands. It goes thus: we demand for state resident data census for an advance.
And you said we demanded for state resident data census for advance to share with our system of all citizens. I'm not asking, is it possible with the economic situation in this country? Census are also to be 10 years. The last one we had was 2006. I was also have data in 2016. But due to economic situation, we couldn't do it. But now that the value of dollar has gone down drastically, do you think it's possible to have census? And we are giving the government a
ultimatum.
Is that not possible?
Apportioning billions of naira for the innovation of National Assembly. See, why all these Western countries that we are trying to copy, why they were able to successfully have a lockdown of over 1 month, 2 months in their country?
was because they already have the data. They have the data of all their citizens. There's not, it is more, it is not difficult for Nigerians. Now, the chairman of this local government cannot wake up on Monday and tell us the the number of the population of the residents in this local government. That is too bad. We must start from somewhere. If the government had, and that was one of the reasons why they were unable to succeed on that palliative, because they don't have the data, they end up giving the palliative to their party members, believing that they will get out the people they want to send to. Until they do the needful, they don't need to get to the party leaders before they get to the people. If they do the needful by doing a proper censor and system, for social system, then when they have the numbers, they know that if you are disbursing anything to Adimosho local government, this is the total number of the population of people in Adimosho. If it's going to Koshove, they must get to know that. It's not difficult for them to do. It's only they don't want to do it. Another question. Mr.
Yes. So I wanted to ask you one on the recent reduction of petroleum price. Recently. Okay, my name is Syracuse. I report for PLS. So I want to ask you two questions. One is, what is your take on the recent increase of petroleum products from 100 and to the, do you think it is reasonable for the amount to increase the oil? Or did the government need to reduce it more, lower, because of the economic situation in Nigeria and even in the world?
Reduced to from 110 to 125 naira.
Yes. No, they have gone down now to 110.
110 naira.
Yes.
Let's say 100 naira.
Yes.
Okay.
Then the second question is, having appraisal of the whole situation of this lockdown, do you think government has actually impacted in controlling the spread of this coronavirus? And if not, what do you think should be done to protect the Nigerians, especially the Lagos, where we are inside?
Thank you. Let me respond. One, the first one, reduction of petroleum pump price to 108 naira is not the best. It cannot work. Like what we have said it earlier on, what is in our speech, that now they ordered the commercial vehicle operators to take 60% of passengers of their total number. Meanwhile, they have to increase the rate, the transport fee, and this is what we are witnessing now. Between, I can witness, you know, from Kedu to Maryland, supposed to be 100 naira, it's now 200. You understand me? Because they have to buy fuel. 100 naira, at this point, there's nothing wrong if the Nigerian government subsidize the commercial vehicle operators with fuel so that it can be easy for them not to increase the rate of transportation, because from 125 naira to 110 naira, there's nothing to move.
Comrade Allen, I'm not saying for this press conference. My question is just a simple question, because I want to agree with you that our government is 100% failure, and we are already disappointed in them. Even in this Lagos State, for example, I'm a member of Lagos State Plans and Community Material Market Association, executive member, where His Excellency Sanwo-Olu, governor of Lagos State, came out, make a press release that every registered association in this Lagos State will benefit from this palliatives, whereby today, as I'm speaking to you, nothing has been given to me.